Australian cattle dog, also known as a blue and red heeler. Really, really cool herding breed developed in Australia in 19th century to drive cattle over long distances in rough terrain. Breed with unwavering work ethics. Always ready to work, always happy to work, and can go all day literally. Yeah, that's me right there on a horse. I made this video to show this specific pack of dogs I have known for 25 years, generation after generation, and to talk a little bit about importance of genetics and selection for solid working sound dog. To live and work on cattle farm, dog must possess certain qualities. Be tough mentally and physically, be independent, have good guardian instinct, be able to work in a pack with other dogs and not to have dog-to-dog aggression, have good engagement with the human masters, be able to listen, have good pain tolerance, have fast muscle twitch to be able to move out quickly when cow kicks, to be fearless and have self-preservation. Lack of any of those qualities simply can get dog killed. This is where natural selection through work comes in play. Those dogs start to work as early as 4 months old, all alone following the older dogs. And if they not, they out. Pack of good working dogs on ranch like that replaces several human workers. And sometimes they really are lifesaver. No one here trains dogs for a living. None of them are dog trainers. No one teaches them to perform those tasks. They're born with needed qualities and they're following their genetic calling. They work hard, they play harder. This is one of the favorite games, the chase game. Look how fast this little dog going, 50 kilometers an hour, 52. That will be little over 30 miles an hour. Wow. Always ready to work, but always ready to play as well. Now it's almost evening, all work is done. Favorite spot to observe the mountains. One looking one way, another one looking another way. The light one is a puppy. They live together, they eat together, they sleep at night outside, and they make a great guardian. Several times a week they kill some kind of coyote that's come close to baby cows here at the ranch. Some dogs at this park are 10 years old. 2 years ago, one of my favorite all-time dogs passed away from old age. His name was Buzz. He was 17 years old. Buzz fully worked till he was 15 years old on this ranch. Back to genetics. Like I mentioned before, those dogs don't get any professional training. They just born knowing what to do. However, with little bit of training, those dogs can be taken to whole another level easily, because genetically they already have everything needed and a little guidance produces phenomenal results. This is Eleazar and his first working dog, Chapo. Eleazar not professional dog trainer. I remember 2 years ago when Chapo was a puppy, he asked me how can I make him to always recall. How can I make him to go left and right on command, to down a distance? We spoke a bit and I explained him how dogs work and learn, the importance of playing with dogs and building relationship, and I was stunned by results he achieved with Chapo. Absolutely incredible working team.
Chapo, in good. Here, chef. Out. In good. Down, no, then I.
The reason it was so easy to train this dog, because of his genetics. He born with all the needed qualities, so the training was easy and enjoyable for his owner. Can't really call it training, just playing. Now back to Cana Corso. In Cana Corso, we don't have 100 years of selective breeding for specific tasks. We have a very small amount of breeders worldwide who strive to select for quality dog generation after generation. There is not many breeders that work their dogs, but they're out there. Everyone wants Cana Corso for protection and guardian, but if you select your puppy from generation of couch potatoes, guess what you're gonna get? A couch potato. DNA don't lie.